Hello everyone, this is Kruti Patel from Pharmaceutical Technology Department, LJ Institute of Pharmacy. Now, in this session, we are going to learn our last jar, which was remaining. The last jar, which is remaining, is freeze dryer, or it is also known as lyophilizer. Now, let's catch words. Freeze dryer, lyophilizer. Now, lyophilizer, that means an equipment which works on the process of lyophilization. So that means you should know what is the process of lyophilization. Okay, so we are not going on lyophilization. Let's catch easy words first. So I guess freeze drying is easy word, right? Okay, freeze dryer means which is freezing something and drying. Okay, so that is freeze dryer. Okay, now what is lyophilization? Lyophilization means freezing and then drying. That is lyophilization. Okay, so that is lyophilizer. Now easy, what is freeze dryer, or that is also known as lyophilizer. Okay, now in this dryer, actually what usually what we do, we first go to diagram. We understand diagram and then we move towards principle, right? Now in this case, understanding diagram and then moving to mechanism is not possible. Okay, so for this particular dryer, we will be starting with principle only. Okay, now before starting principle, I would like to remind you about phase diagram. You have already studied about phase diagram, right? How we can construct phase diagram? You have to plot it against temperature versus pressure, right? Temperature will be your, pressure will be your. Okay, now that phase diagram shows three different parts. How? Let me try again. Okay, so this part should be at zero, right? I'm not able to draw it properly. Okay, now temperature versus pressure graph. This is a solid state, this is a liquid state for any material, and this is a vapor state. Okay, so what happens at specific pressure and specific temperature? Any material can either be solid, liquid, or vapor. But there is one point which is known as triple point, right? This is known as triple point. Triple point is a point that is at particular pressure and temperature. Your product can exist in three different states, that is solid, liquid, and vapor. Okay, so that is triple point. Now, why we are discussing this phase diagram? Because to understand freeze dryer, we should remember this phase diagram. Okay, how? Because that works on a principle of sublimation. Now, what is the sublimation? This line is known as sublimation. Okay, now what is sublimation? Sublimation means conversion of solid to vapor. Conversion of solid directly to vapor. That means you have a piece of ice. You have one ice with you. Okay, when you keep it out at atmospheric temperature and pressure, what happens? That will start converting into liquid. Okay, so solid is converting into liquid and then it is vaporizing. So it is converted into vapor state. This is how actual transition takes place, right? But in case of sublimation, your solid product will be directly converted into vapor without changing or without converting into liquid state. That is known as sublimation. Okay, so same principle is applied in freeze dryer. That means first of all, you have to freeze your product. First of all, you have to convert your product into solid form. That means all the water part you are converting into solid part. And now that water part you are converting into directly vapor part without letting it convert into liquid phase. Okay, so that is sublimation. And this is how freeze dryer works. Is everybody getting? Because this is important part. Okay, so let's start with the principle. In freeze dryer, water is removed from frozen state by sublimation, that is, direct change of water from solid into vapor without conversion into a liquid phase. For this, we should remember the phase diagram, right? The drying is achieved by subjecting the material to temperature and pressure below the triple point. Okay, again, we have to draw that diagram. This is solid, this is liquid, and this is vapor, right? This is temperature, this is pressure. So, and this is my triple point, right? Okay, so below triple point, the drying is achieved by subjecting the material to temperature and pressure below the triple point. That means if I set temperature and pressure below triple point, so what happens? My product directly from solid that directly converts into vapor state here. Okay, that means what I have to do? I have to reduce pressure and I have to reduce temperature. Right, my product is in liquid form here. So to convert it into solid form first, what I have to do? I have to reduce temperature. Okay, so that will be converted into solid form. Then what I have to do? I have to reduce pressure. So once I reduce pressure, what happens? My product, my solid part will directly convert it into vapor state. This is how it works. Okay. Chalo. Let's start with the construction. The construction is shown in diagram. It consists of how many important parts? Four important parts. First is drying chamber, in which trays are loaded. The materials to be dried are kept in these trays. Second is heat supply in the form of radiation source or heating coils. Third is vapor condensing or adsorption system. This vapor condensing surface is cooled by carbon dioxide with acetone or ethanol, and last is vacuum pump. So there are four important parts. First is drying chamber, second is heat supply, third is vapor condensing or adsorption system, and last is vacuum pump. See, this is the diagram. Okay, these are the trays on which you have to keep your material. So first of all, your material will be converted into solid form. The material should be in liquid form, then it is converted into solid form. Okay, so this is solid form. This is the door. These are the heated shelves, means this is for the freezing, this is for the heating. Okay, so your air will come out through this part to vacuum. It means this is the point to create a vacuum. Heat transfer will take place through this area. This is refrigerant, and this is isolation valve. Okay, as I said, diagram and principle has no connection. Okay, let's start with the working. Okay, for the freeze drying or for the lyophilization process, the important part is first you have to reduce temperature and then you have to apply vacuum. First you are reducing temperature and then you have to reduce pressure. How you can reduce pressure? By creating vacuum. Okay, so first is reducing temperature and then second is reducing vacuum. Okay, so this is important. So it works, it consists of the following steps. First is preparation and pre-treatment. Second is freezing. Third is primary drying. Fourth is secondary drying. And last is packaging. Now let's understand them in detail. First is preparation and pre-treatment. Why preparation and pre-treatment is essential? Because in case of freeze dryer, only small amount of sample can be processed at one time. So you need to reduce the bulk of your product. So for that, pre-treatment is always essential. Let's study them in detail. Only small amount of solution can be handled during one cycle. So for the proper drying process, pre-treatment is essential. The solution is pre-concentrated. It is pre-concentrated, right? Under normal vacuum tray dryer, this reduces the actual drying by 8 to 10 times. Now, normal vacuum tray dryer. How vacuum tray dryer works? Tray dryer, you all know what is tray dryer, right? Now, vacuum tray dryer means you have to operate tray dryer at reduced pressure. Once you reduce pressure, what happens? The temperature or boiling point elevation of water takes place. Now, what is this boiling point elevation? Sorry, boiling point suppression of water takes place. Now, what is this boiling point suppression? The boiling point for the water is 100 degrees Celsius, right? Degree Celsius, right? Now, boiling point suppression means you are reducing boiling point. Means if you apply vacuum, then the boiling point of water will reduce, will come down. That means it is dependent on vacuum. How much vacuum you are applying, then boiling point will come down. That comes down to around approximately 30 degrees Celsius at 3 mmHg. Okay, so if you reduce pressure to 3 mmHg, then your pressure will come down to sorry, your temperature will the boiling point of water will come down to around 30 to 40 degrees Celsius. Okay, so that is known as boiling point suppression. So how you can concentrate, pre-concentrate, how you can pre-concentrate your solution? You can pre-concentrate your solution under normal vacuum tray dryer. This reduces the actual drying by 8 to 10 times. Okay. Now, next part is freezing. Vials, ampoules, or bottles in which the aqueous solution is packed are frozen in cold shells at about minus 50 degrees Celsius at atmospheric pressure. Here we are not reducing pressure. This steps works on atmospheric pressure only. You have to chill your compound at minus 50 degrees Celsius. It can be minus 60 or minus 70, whatever. Okay, so the range actually is minus 50 to minus 70 degrees Celsius. Then comes your primary drying. Okay, in freezing, you are doing at atmospheric pressure. What you are reducing? You are reducing temperature. Okay. Now, in case of drying, in this case, the temperature is already reduced. Now, what you have to reduce? You have to reduce pressure. So, let's look at them in detail. In this step, the material to be dried is spread in as much as large surface possible. The temperature and pressure should be below triple point so that the sublimation, that is direct change of solid water into vapor without conversion into liquid phase of water, takes place. Vacuum is applied, that is 3 mmHg vacuum is applied to the frozen sample. The temperature is linearly increased to about 30 degrees Celsius in span of 2 hours. That means then gradually you have to increase temperature to 30 degrees Celsius, and that takes around 2 hours. Okay, not immediately, gradually you have to increase. This primary drying stage removes easily removable moisture, that is almost 98 to 99% of water is removed. So what is important part of, in freeze drying? First of all, you have to reduce temperature, and then you have to reduce pressure. Why we need to do this? Because we have seen phase diagram. In phase diagram, we have to reduce temperature and pressure below triple point so that sublimation takes place, that is directly conversion of solid phase into vapor state without converting into liquid state. Okay, so this is important. This you have to mention specially. Okay, then secondary drying. After primary drying comes your secondary drying. The secondary drying is actually removal of only 1 to 2% moisture. Okay, and so that takes almost around 10 to 20 hours. Let's look at them in detail. During this stage, remaining traces of moisture is removed. The temperature of the solid is raised to as high as 50 to 60 degrees Celsius. Temperature is increased, right? But vacuum is lowered below, that is used in the primary drying. In the primary drying, we had used vacuum at 3 mmHg. Okay, what is the normal atmospheric pressure? The normal atmospheric pressure is 760 mmHg. Okay, so you are reducing to 3 mmHg. And but the vacuum is lowered below that is used in primary drying, that is 50 mmHg. And the rate of drying is very low and it takes about 10 to 20 hours. Okay. Now, after your compound is completely dried, the packaging comes. After vacuum is replaced by inert gas, the bottles and vials are closed. That means once you are done with drying, you have to replace vacuum with the inert gas. Okay, otherwise, if you expose it to atmospheric pressure and temperature, what happens? The oxygen will come in and oxidation of product or degradation of product may take place. So you have to replace it with inert gas, and then bottles and vials are closed. What are the uses? Okay, so I guess the working is clear. If you talk about working, then it is divided into five parts. First is preparation and pre-treatment. Second is freezing. Third is primary drying. Fourth is secondary drying. And fifth is packing. In case of pre-treatment and preparation, you have to explain why it is required. Then freezing, minus 50 to minus 70 degrees Celsius range. Primary drying, reducing vacuum. Secondary drying to remove 1 to 2% of remaining moisture, which is lengthier process. And finally, packaging. Okay, so that is working. Let's move towards uses. This dryer is most commonly used in the production of dosage forms such as injections, solutions, and suspensions. Also used for the drying of plasma and blood plasma and its products, bacterial and viral cultures, human tissue, antibiotics and plant extracts, steroids, vitamins, and enzymes. Several other products, food products such as prawns, mushrooms, meat, poultry products, tea and coffee concentrates, citrus fruit juices, they all are dried by this method. Okay, so this is again very important, a very useful method of drying, same as that of spray dryer, but this lyophilization process is quite costly compared to spray dryer. Let's look at the advantages. Thermolabile materials can be dried. The product retains its bulk volume, therefore it will be porous and uniform, and thus reconstitution of material is easy. What is reconstitution? I have already explained. Loss of volatile material is less, yes, because we are not increasing temperature much. Then material can be dried in its final container, such as single dose and multiple dose vials. Sterility can be maintained, yes, that means it can be used to it can be used for the drying of sterile products. Then disadvantages. Product is prone to oxidation due to high porosity and large surface area. Therefore, product should be packed in vacuum or using inert gas or in a container impervious to gases. In last part, that is working's last part, packing, I have already explained you why we should apply inert gas. Otherwise, what happens? Oxidation takes place. Okay, so that is the major disadvantage. Then equipment and running cost are high. It is actually too high. It is difficult to adapt the method for solutions containing non-aqueous solvents. Why non-aqueous solvents? Because it is difficult to convert them into solid phase. The period of drying is high, rarely less than 10 hours. Time cannot be shortened. This process consumes 10 hours. That is compulsory. You no reduction or no concession or nothing can be done in this part. Okay, so this was about freeze dryer, or that is also known as lyophilizer. The important part is you have to reduce temperatures, and your product will be converted into solid. Your water will be converted into solid. Then gradually you have to decrease pressure again. First decrease temperature, then decrease pressure. So what happens? There comes a point below triple point where your product, your water will be directly converted from solid to vapor without converting into liquid phase. This is important part. Okay, so this was all about freeze dryer or lyophilizer. If you still have any doubts, you can ask me. And stay home, stay safe, and keep reading.